Good morning, everybody. This is Abdullah Siddiqui from Siddiqui Car Sales. And I got an extra special treat for you guys today. I'm actually going to be filming a day in the life of a car salesman. This is something that I've been wanting to do for a while, but I just haven't had time for it. So I'm finally getting around to it, so I'm pretty excited. I hope you guys enjoy the video. But it is like 7:35, so I'm actually running kind of behind today, which is hilarious. It's the perfect day to start this. But I'm gonna get ready and then I will be right back. So guys, I'm actually running kind of behind, but I'm ready to go for the morning. I'm gonna make my way to the dealership and you guys are gonna see some things in between. So let's go. Is it bad sometimes? I like it when I lose control. There's something in it that's so beautiful. So I guess while you guys watch this little montage, I should probably tell you why I decided to make these videos. And honestly, it's more or less because I wanted to educate everybody about the car business and what really goes on in our day-to-day lives. I think there's a lot of bad stigma around the car business, around car salesmen, sales managers, anything like that. And I just wanted to show everyone that our job is just like everybody else's job. We all get up in the morning, we all drive to work. Right now I'm just getting my morning drive in, and I love this because it gives me a time by myself to get myself prepared for the day. Sometimes I wish it was a little bit of a longer drive. Don't tell my boss that though, because he might cuss me out since he drives from Easton every day, which is about an hour away from our dealership. So yeah guys, I think we're coming up to the dealership now, so enjoy the rest of the video. Alright guys, so we are here. And I can see the light but I can also see the bones again. I don't know what else there is to say. I'm doing my best not to run away. So we are here, and I'm just going around and unlocking all the doors so we can get started for this morning. I know I said I was running late this morning, but I was running late for myself. I'm actually here before everyone else. I like doing that anyway because it helps me get the day started. I can get sales log completed, check what we did yesterday because I was off, and you know, get on that start. All right, so please excuse my desk. It is kind of messy, but I actually am not a salesman anymore. That's the cool thing. I actually got promoted to sales manager. But this actually works a little bit better because not only can I show you what goes throughout a salesman's day, but I can also show you a couple of other cool things as well. Now, also, it's the only reason I can actually do this because I actually have time to sit down and do other things other than just being on the phone, emailing, looking for ups all day, because as a salesman, that is your primary job focus. And if you're really doing that all the time, you won't have time to do anything else. That's the whole reason why all the lot walks and things like that are filmed on the weekends or on Sundays, because frankly, if I was trying to do lot walks and this, it wouldn't work. I wouldn't have time to do one or the other, or one would turn out really crappy. So what I'm gonna do is actually meet up with you guys when I do my little early morning lot walk. I know, right? We're gonna make another one. But it's actually just what I do personally to walk the lot, and what every salesperson does as well every morning, just to see what we have out there.
So walking the lot in the morning is really important, especially when you're the sales manager, because it's good to know what inventory you have out here. But as a salesperson, you need to do it, because if you have a customer that comes in, not everything is on the website. A majority of these cars, you know, they have to go through the shop. You want to know where they are. So I'm just going to give you guys a quick look around. The biggest part of a salesman's day is to make every single phone call they physically can on their planner. So our planner is called Elite CRM. Basically, it organizes every customer that we have, and then, you know, it tells us our next tasks as far as phone follow-ups, birthdays, things like that. And it's really important to do so, one, to make sure you're reaching out to previous customers and to make sure that you're interacting with them, but also to make sure you stay on top of people that are looking for vehicles so you can customize the experience for them. So it tells us exactly what vehicle in our lot that they're interested in, and, you know, we go from there. So, you know, if I was a salesman, usually a good median is to make 50, 60 calls in a day. Break that up however way you want. If you're here all day, you know, you can do it in 20 call sections, you know, three times a day. So you can make 20 calls in the morning, 20 in the afternoon, and 20 before you leave. Whichever way works for you. So it's been a pretty uneventful day. Not eventful. It is 12 o'clock now, which means it's lunchtime. So you guys are gonna follow me to lunch. The most important part about, you know, staying in high hopes on a day like this, especially a day that's been so slow from the start, is just to keep hitting the phones. Whether you're a salesman, manager, whatever it is, it's the same basic principle. The best way to bring people in is to get on the phone, get through those emails, and bring them in here. The good thing about our dealership is that, you know, everybody still has the freedom and it's not super stress-based. So even on a day where we're pretty slow or we're not doing, you know, as much activity as we want to, everyone can still go through their day pretty comfortably. It's not a stressful environment. But again, it does suck a little bit when it's 12 o'clock and you haven't had one customer yet. But it's time to eat lunch. Make yourself feel a little better. Down for lunch, the first appraisal of the day. Great, that's exactly how it is every single time. So basically, we got a couple in here that are looking to trade out of their GMC Acadia for one of our used GMC Yukons. They need a little bit more space, So what we're gonna do, appraise their vehicle, see what it's worth, make sure they like our Yukon, and from there, hopefully we can make something happen. So what I can tell you from the appraisal is it's a pretty average car, doesn't need brakes, doesn't need anything like that. So we should be able to make this happen. This day is starting to get interesting. We got ourselves a SL550 to appraise. That's gonna be fun. She's a little old, but man, yeah, I'm gonna have fun with this one. So I don't know if you guys saw, but slowly throughout my day, my outfit got a whole lot less unprofessional. But we actually did end up doing two today, which is usually our goal. At least two or three cars out in the day, and it'll keep us on track. But it was a pretty slow day. We didn't get much activity until the very end. That's why I couldn't film as much. I showed you guys our two trades. So as you guys can see here, we're just walking the lot. So this is what I usually do around the end of the day. It is 7 o'clock, so you know, we'll be getting out of here in an hour. But I just walk around, make sure everything's where it's supposed to be. If any cars have been moved out of place, then we got to move them back. But I hope this showed you guys a little bit of what, you know, what a day inside the dealership is like. All the things that we end up doing. Yeah, I'm just going to do a quick walk and then we'll sign out for the night. Well, we are right back where we started this morning, and the desk is still as messy as it was this morning, but I hope that showed you guys a little bit of a glimpse of what our day-to-day is here at the dealership. I know I wasn't able to show you the thorough process, and that's just because it's very hard to show you organically what's going on and film it at the same time, unless I'm filming the entire time. So I had to do some breaks here and there. But hopefully that gave you a little bit of an idea of, you know, what the actual process is. I'll do a couple more videos if you guys end up liking this. If this makes it to a couple of homes and this brings in some people, or you know, this interests people more to the car dealership, please go ahead, leave some comments, any questions, any concerns that you might have. But with that, I think I'm gonna call it a night, and I'm gonna let myself go home. I'm gonna let everybody else go home, and see you guys next time.